Up at the state capitol today during a debate over a controversial prison reform bill. It squeaked through the assembly this afternoon, lawmakers arguing whether it puts the public at risk. And now some are taking a closer look at what went wrong in Dugard's case. KCRA3's Lindsay Paula reports.
And we know the kind of programs that work.
The state assembly barely passed the bill that would cut the corrections budget by $1.2 billion and reduce prison overcrowding. Republicans call it an assault on public safety. Crime victims groups agree, saying what happened to J.C. Lee Dugard shows a failing system which would only get worse.
The problem that we see with this is that there isn't adequate supervision of parolees as it is.
California's parole department took over Philip Garrido's case, Dugard's captor, in 1999. Average caseloads are 70 to 1. Garrido's parole agent had a caseload of 40 to 1, according to the department. And under the prison reform bill, that would be the new caseload for agents, who would focus their efforts on the most serious violent offenders.
It doesn't seem like it's the caseload is the problem. It seems like we have to pay more attention to the detail of what's going on.
Victims' advocates and now some lawmakers want to know more about what went on in the Dugard case. KCRA 3 requested Garrido's record of supervision from Corrections. Corrections has not released the records, saying it's doing an internal review and assisting law enforcement with the investigation.
Public safety is a concern of everyone, and they need to be transparent and show us what has been going on.
Quite frankly, if somebody screwed up, then they need to say, hey, we need to learn from that.
In Sacramento, Lindsay Paulo, KCRA 3 reports.
That prison bill now moves to the Senate. Its fate there is not clear. President Pro Tem Daryl Steinberg says he won't allow a vote on the assembly bill unless it includes some of the provisions of the earlier bill.